Hello everyone, students, it's day 7 and let's today start with artificial vegetative propagation, in which new plants, they are produced from vegetative parts of the plants but by artificial methods. There are three methods of artificial vegetative propagation. One is cutting, then layering and then grafting. Let's discuss them one by one. First is cutting. Here new plants are produced from cutting of the plants. It can be cutting of a root or stem or leaf. Example is rose plant. In this, stem is cut in such a way that it should contain few buds, right? And then this portion is buried in the soil. After few days we can see these roots also start developing and shoots also develop and it grows to form a new rose plant. Another example of vegetative propagation from stem cutting, that is money plant. Cutting of the stem of money plant is taken in such a way that it should contain at least one leaf. The point where leaf is attached to the stem is known as node. When we dip this portion in a container, water bottle or plastic bottle filled with water, we can see after few days the roots start developing and it grows into a complete money plant. Other examples of this are banana and sugarcane, in which new plants are produced by cutting, right, of stem. Next is layering. Layering is done in plants having flexible stems and branch of the plant is pulled towards the ground in such a way that the this branch that is buried in the soil in such a way that tip of the plant that is exposed above the ground. And after few days we can see that in the buried part the roots start appearing, shoot that grows upwards, and later on this middle portion is cut. Like in this picture we can see from one parent plant these become three plants are produced, right? This is an example of jasmine or chameli, in which layering that is done. And other examples of vegetative propagation by layering, they are strawberry, bougainvillea and lemon. Let's discuss the third one, very important. This is grafting. Grafting is an important method of artificial vegetative propagation, in which two stems are taken from two different plants. One is taken with roots, another is taken without roots, in such a way that two stems are then joined together, grow as a single plant. Right, and new plant formed that will have the characteristics of both the original plants. This we can see in the picture also. I'll show you the cut part of the plant or tree which is having roots that is fixed in the soil and that is known as stalk, and the stem of other plant which is to be grafted, that is called as scion, that is fixed up onto the stalk. Here you can see in this picture now two stems are taken from two different plants. This is which is fixed in the soil, which is with roots, that is known as stalk, and this is grafted onto this with both are given slanting cuts. This is a technique, you know students, grafting is done in a particular technique. This cut is given in slanting way, right, in such a way that phloem and xylem, they should come in contact with each other of both the stems, right? And later on this portion which is without roots, that is known as scion, and then these two are joined together with the help of polythene, or we can say some plastic sheet, or with the help of thread, or we wrap it with the help of some cloth, in such a way that after few days it heals up, right, and it grows into a new plant. Examples in which grafting is done, that is apple, peach, apricot and pear trees. And now let's discuss the advantages of vegetative propagation. As you know, many plants can be grown from one parent plant. This, you know, is an advantage of vegetative propagation. Then second, new plants produced by vegetative propagation can bear fruits and flowers earlier than those produced from seeds, as we discussed in potato tuber, vegetative propagation by potato tubers. Next is the plants produced are genetically similar to the parent plant to have all its characteristics. This is also simple, you can easily understand. Next is we can get seedless plants from vegetative propagation, right? Example is grafting. We can have different varieties of seedless plants also, and we can have a variety of different flowers as well as fruits by grafting. And now this slide is for homework. You have to do in your notebooks. Thank you, students. Take care.